Hello YouTube, welcome back to my channel. This is AAA X-Ray, and today I'm going to do a solo game of Action Allies, and this is the Young Grasshopper Tournament Edition. And I'm doing a solo game just to check out the strategies and to share with you where I'm at with my strategies at this moment. And this is a kind of test, so my strategies and my considerations will change probably even because of this game and games to come. So, but we'll see. This is just content that should open up some discussion. In this edition, the turn order has changed, but Germany is still first. I put here the purchase of Germany. What I do is a carrier and two transports, and that is believe that helps me the most with the different objectives that I can go for. So Germany can go, in my opinion, three ways with its strategy. That is, of course, going after Russia to try to get the victory cities, and in that way get a victory objective for the amount of victory cities. Another viable victory objective is taking London, and another one is to support Italy take Africa. So in the first turn for Germany, I do not really want to give away what I'm going to do. I want to leave the options open. And I think this buy of one carrier and two transports helped me with that, because I want to build them in the Z-Zone 112. And if I build it now, it will give me the option to land some troops in, for example, Morocco or Gibraltar in the second turn. And it all depends also on what Japan is doing and what the US is buying. So maybe that is not a feasible move, that we just don't do it, but it is an option when we buy this, and if we do that, that can really help this objective of Northern Africa. And it also depends how Italy is doing. If Italy is doing very bad, it's not probably not worth going here, and perhaps just it's better for Germany to pursue its own objectives. Another viable objective for Germany is to go after London. Also, this purchase will help in the second turn. Germany can buy another 10 transports, 9 or 10 transports, and then in turn 3 it will have considerable force that is able to reach London. And also that depends a lot just on how things are developing, what will be the purchases and the moves of London. So how well will it be defended? If it is not feasible, then Germany should not do it. But if it is feasible, Germany should definitely do it, because then England would be out of the game for a large part, will not be able to purchase at least for a few rounds. So that will give Italy a better position. Now for Germany, if both the objectives of London or the Africa don't work out for one or another reason, then by default it will put all its energy in Russia and try to capture Moscow. So, but in the beginning, first turn, it doesn't really matter yet. We're going to prepare. We'll just do basically traditional moves, just to clear the Atlantic, take Paris, and do that kind of things. So what I will do is I'll move the pieces, throw the dice, and then we'll see what is the result. So here, quick summary of all the attacks. Two submarines will go into the CISO 106 to take out the fleet, the battleship and a sub. Three fighters and three tacticals try to take out this combined Allied fleet. Two subs, one fighter, one tactical, and two strategic bombers will take out this fleet. Then there will be the Battle of Normandy. Sorry, here with two infantry and artillery and a tank. Everything else that can reach will go into to Paris. I put it on the battle board to make it not too chaotic. And here, so in Yugoslavia, we'll have six infantry, two artillery, a tank, a fight, and a tactical coming in. Okay, so that was the first round of combat for Germany. And yeah, something very stupid happened. Paris failed, and it failed so badly that I decided to redo it, because that would make a very awkward game and was not really the content I was going for today. So I leave in the footage. Basically what happened is Germany missed everything but one the first round. France had a little bit better than average hits, so that really turned the tide. And then at the end of the combat, France still had even one infantry left over. So I decided this would change the game so much that I redo this battle. But in a real match, it would be a very funny game. Very funny to see where they would be going. But yeah, as I said, it's not really what I was going for to test strategies. So yeah, we redid it and we ended up with a very average outcome. Germany have its tanks left over, two artillery and two mechs. The other combats went quite well for Germany. Here two subs are left over. We lost one fighter in 111. We lost nothing, not even a hit, not even a damaged battleship in 110. And then we lost two infantry here in Yugoslavia. Okay, so I will do the non-combats. So Germany is finished. The port is cleaned up. So I put those dice there to remind me that will be a convoy for in UK's turn. Fleet is here in sea zone 112. And now you can also see that with free transports, I can pick up the remaining forces from Normandy, plus some infantry from Denmark. So I've all my transport loaded if I want to go here to Morocco. I landed one plane here in Rome, one plane in Tobruk. All the other Luftwaffe landed in Western Germany, and all the other forces are getting ready to go into Russia. For the money, Germany was at 30. It conquered territories for 11 IPC. It takes the money from Rome, and it has two national objectives of 5 IPC. So that makes together 70 IPC that it will take to the next turn. So next in the turn order in the Young Grasshopper tournament edition is UK Pacific, which is a new nation. There's 27 IPC to spend, and I will spend it on one infantry, a tank, a mech, a submarine and a destroyer. So my philosophy for UK Pacific is quite simple. I think they should really focus on the Pacific. And I do give I lend a hand to the UK Europe, because I think in the, especially in the beginning, situation in Cairo requires a little bit support. But I will not move much more to the European side of the board. I think it's much better if a nation will focus And because the UK Pacific is concentrated in the Pacific, has two factories on the Pacific side, it should focus on the Pacific side. So they will fight Japan. They will do it as much as possible in an economic way. So I don't really pursue, especially not in the beginning of the game, any real objectives, like victory objectives or anything. I just want to stay healthy and take as much IPC from Japan as possible. So try to deny them the money islands. Try to keep forces in China. I want to prevent the China token from falling into the Japanese hands. I think it's very difficult to actually achieve any objectives for the UK Pacific because they're quite easy to deny by the Japanese. At least they should not give anything to the Japanese. So they will just be a pain in the neck for Japan. So they will just shuffle their units around. We will look at it when it is done. UK Pacific is done, and you see it moved a little invasion force here in Africa. It only comprises of two infantry and a fighter, and also moved the two infantry from Cairo down to Anglo-Egyptian Sudan. This is to put pressure on Italy. It depends on what happens on UK Europe's turn. It might move another infantry here. So then for Italy, it's not very wise to go into here. And that means it cannot use those forces to put pressure on Cairo. And again, this depends a lot on what's happening on UK's turn and how well it goes on UK's turn. If I'm Italy, I would attack this force. The odds are a little bit in favor of the UK Pacific here because it has the fighter. Italy has a little bit more hit points, so I would attack it as a UK Pacific. I just accept that I might lose all those units, and if it doesn't, I will use them to hurt the Italians here. If the fighter survives, it will go to Cairo, stay there as a defense. The transport might return, or it might not. The reason why I do not want to send the cruiser here is because I want to concentrate my fleet in this area. So since I start with my battleship and the cruiser from 63 and the destroyer from 62, so I want to build up a fleet here that can actually threaten Japan. So I don't want to send anything away in a different direction. So that's what I'm doing here. I put one infantry in New Guinea. It might walk on Dutch New Guinea later, just for the national objective. There's a good chance that the transport will survive because it's not really favorable for Japan to attack in its first turn. So if it does, we will lose the transport, but otherwise we will just retreat it and then we will still have it. Here in India, we build a new land unit. And we moved everything here in Burma just to start threatening Japan. We're not allowed to declare war yet, but we want to have it in place. And we want to be able to go into Yunnan to support China, probably with holding the road, or at least or denying Japan to have the victory token. So after its first turn, UK Pacific will have it the same income, did not conquer any territory or grab any neutral territory. So it will have again 27 IPC, and then the turn will go to Japan. So now it's Japan's turn. As Japan, I buy one minor industrial complex and two transports. And here the philosophy is that actually I want to pursue the China token. I think that's a very viable strategy, but I cannot ignore the UK Pacific, especially if I already see that they focus primarily on the Pacific. So I want to be financially healthy with Japan, so I will go for the money islands. And that's why I also buy the two transports, and I want to threaten Calcutta, where UK Pacific down as much as possible. And then I hope that I will achieve the China token. So for Japan, I have four comets planned. They're all here in China. So it's with the objective to move the Chinese back. I do not plan to attack the UK Pacific or the US. The UK Pacific is not so interesting to attack at this moment because, of course, well, the battleship has moved away here. I could take out the transport here. I cannot really take out this fleet with a scramble of two fighters. I could attack the US, either here at Hawaii or here at, the Philippines. But I want to keep the US out of the war, because then it will be more difficult to have a successful Sea Lion or the Africa token. And because I think those tokens are much more feasible in the early game, I rather do not attack the US immediately. Give Germany a little bit more time and see how the board develops at that side. And just here focus on China. Well, not surprisingly, Japan won all the battles. But in Yunnan, China had three hits. So that is quite good for China. But Yunnan was taken without hits. So now we do all the non-combat moves. So Japan did all its non-combat moves. So you see all the planes have landed here. Also, Japan brought in some ground forces with the transports. So they have a small fleet here off the coast of Formosa on Taiwan. There's also a little fleet. It can pick up a couple of those units. Here is the main fleet of the Japan. Two transports here. So basically what Japan could do is that there's now three transports in range of the islands here and Malaya, and the two transports can reach the Philippines. So in a next turn, Japan could hit the Allies very hard at all fronts. Yeah, and basically that's it for Japan. Japan had a starting income of 26. So it now it has four territories from China. So that's an additional four, and it has 10 extra for the NO of not being at war at the United States. So they have now 40 IPC to spend in the next turn. And then the turn goes to UK Europe. So UK Europe has 28 IPC to spend. In case you're wondering, for me the grey are 10s, the red are 5s and the greens are 1s. So yeah, that's that. UK Europe will buy 9 infantry because there's a serious threat for a Sea Lion. So I must do anything to protect London. So that costs 27 IPC. So they will keep 1 IPC. And yeah, that's the buy. UK Europe did quite bad in the Atlantic in the Germany's turn. That means they have to deal with two subs here in sea zone 106 and an undamaged battleship in 110 with a submarine, And then, yeah, other than that, I want to do a quite traditional opening move here and try Taranto, and want to take out this fleet. So we'll see how that goes. So the common moves are as follows. So here, three fighters from the UK, the cruiser and a destroyer will attack 110. The fighter from Gibraltar will take a shot at this destroyer and transport. And then we'll go into this sea zone, what is it, 97, with everything that's available. The bomber from London, fighter from Malta, tactical from the fleet, and everything that is here available. I do not send in the fighter from the UK, because I think it's more important to save London. That means that this is a little bit light, and Italy decide to scramble. So two fighters and a tactical will join. So we'll see, will be a little bit hairy, and yeah, a lot depends on the outcome of those battles. So the UK in its turn did very well. It only had a very few losses. It lost its destroyer and carrier here. All the planes survived. Also in Seazone 110, it had not any losses. Also means that they have an effective blocker against the German fleet. So the German fleet cannot move in its combat move in Seazone 91. So it's quite lucky. So we will do the non-combat moves. So one of the non-combat moves that I want to explain is this transport, especially because it went quite well for the UK in this area. I want to peel off one artillery and move it to Prussia. So move the camera. UK Europe is taking Prussia. So I want this area to be strong for UK Europe to fight Italy. Okay, so let's do all the non-combat moves. So as you see, all the planes have retreated to Malta. All but one infantry moved into Egypt, and infantry from Egypt moved into Egypt, Sudan. You cannot see it on the camera. I moved infantry up to Rhodesia here, and the destroyer is now next to the transport in Seazone 76. Yeah, other than that, all the forces here on the blow-up card, you see the all the forces that are in London. So that's the end of the turn for the UK Europe. So it has 28 IPC in the starting position. Picked up another two because it has now Prussia. We have another IPC that we saved, and we get four nanos in this edition, six IPC for having all the original territories. So that makes another, what is it, 20, 30, 37. IPC. We did not lose anything in convoy raids, because the German subs decided to throw sixes and a four. So UK Europe is actually very lucky in this turn. Let's move to Italy. So Italy, it only have 10 IPC to spend, so it will replace one of its fighters. Italy is in a very bad position at this moment. It lost most of its fleet. Did not hit England quite as hard as it should have. So it has the RAF has a big presence here in Malta. Those planes will probably fly to Egypt here in the Horn of Africa. We cannot really go into here, so we probably just attack the UK Pacific Army here in British Somaliland. We'll try to clear the Mediterranean. So I always try to be a little bit conservative with Italy because it cannot replace its losses so very well. But in this case, I want to try to take out both the UK cruiser and the French fleet here. And then I want to take southern France. Let's see. Don't think it's worthwhile to go into here. Maybe. It's a little bit tricky because there's so many planes. I have to think about it. So I thought about it. And those forces that will move into here. Well, Italy was successful in half of the battles. The submarine did not hit, the cruiser hit, so the cruiser survives. Here in British Somaliland, it was a mutual destruction. Here they took a counter hit, just one. Here they also took a counter hit, also one. So they lost this turn. What is it? 5 infantry, an artillery, and a submarine. So it's not great. So for the non-combat, Italy will not do so much, but it will move those 2 infantry in here, and then it will land its fighter in Rome together with the new build, the bomber in Rome, and the fighter will also go into Rome. So this fleet is here. Yeah. So those are all the non-combat moves. So Italy has a starting income of 10. It picks up another 3 because of southern France. So there's 13. There's no NOs. So it's quite meager for Italy. So now it's China's turn. China has 12 IPC to spend. And for that it will buy 4 guys. So China will do only one combat, and it was very lucky. I'm actually using a chopstick, so especially for Japan and China. China was lucky because there only is one artillery here, so we don't need to bring so much. So I will bring the 2 infantry from Guizhou, the fighter, just to be certain, another infantry. That's the whole combat move. So China won the battle. That means the road is open for China, which is a very good thing. So the plane will land in Shenzhen, and that is where also all the other units will move. Plus the newly purchased units will also go in there. So it's the end of the turn for China. So they receive just 9 IPC from their income tracker income. And they receive an extra 6 for the Burma road that is open. So they end up with 15 IPC. So it's Russia's turn. Russia has 37 IPC to spend. It will spend that on 6 artillery, tank, a mech, and an infantry. So the strategy for Russia is quite simple. We don't know yet what Germany will do. Maybe it will go for a sea lion. It will not likely go to Africa. At some time it will come after Russia anyway. So we're going to just build up the defenses. I will just move all the units back to better positions. So that is all for Russia. So you see they make a defensive line here. And just see what happens and what will come at them. And also here they make a defensive line in Buryatia. So at the end of Russia's turn, they will collect exactly the same amount because they did not conquer anything. They don't get any NOs because they're not at war. So 37 IPC. So purchases for US is one carrier, battleship, and two destroyers. So the US is not yet in war, so they can only do the non-combat moves. So what I like to do is I like to keep this fighter here, because if the Japanese land their forces here, I just prefer that he stays here and perhaps kills one or two infantry, then that he tries to go anywhere, because the infantry for Japan are very valuable. This fleet I will move here in 54. Oh, sorry, it's just outside of the view of the camera. Here, 54. Other than that, I gather everything in Hawaiian Islands. Let's see, just the transport will bring with him one artillery and one infantry. And one extra plane will land here. So here's the MAC. I'll drive to Washington. Doesn't matter, it will stay with the other ones here. Really doesn't matter. The bomber, go here just because there's an airbase. I have the fleet here. They'll just move together here. Yeah, then the newly purchased units will be built here. And that was the end of the turn of the US. They again get the same income. Also, they are not at war. They did not take any territory because of that. And they have no NOs. So they end up with 52. Now it's the turn of France. And also they will just move their units around. So that is the end of the first turn. Now we'll go to the second turn. It will be the turn for Germany again. So I will make this the end of this episode. We played one full round. It's already taking quite long. So it's nice to stop here. Thank you. Welcome back. This is the second episode of my solo game of Axis and Allies Grasshopper Edition. And this will be the second game round. We will start again with Germany. So Germany has 70 IPC to spend. I've been considering a Sea Lion, but when we just count the amount of units that are in London and the money that the UK can spend this round, it is probably not worthwhile. So instead, Germany will focus entirely on Russia and purchase accordingly. So this will be the purchase for Germany. 7 MEX, 7 tanks. So the idea is just to get into Russia as quick as possible and hurry all the way to Moscow as quick as they can. So Germany will declare war on Russia and attack it over the whole line. Russia vacated everything, so they're all walk-ons. We have one battle for the cruiser here and one battle for the cruiser here. So Germany was successful in all the battles. Took out the cruiser here, took out the cruiser there. Those are walk-ons. But in the process, both cruisers, they hit. So Germany, we lost two fighters. So let's do the non-combat moves. So I did all the non-combat moves, and I forgot that I had the bombers here in Ukraine to attack. So we have to do that battle. Okay, now Germany is really done, so the bombers will fly back. They had, let's see, two remaining, so they will land here in Bulgaria. So, okay, I made a mistake with the build. Because I have to build some of the mechs somewhere else. I built 7 tanks here, so I can build 3 mechs. So there are actually 5 mechs here. And that, then I have to build 4 mechs here. So sorry for that mistake. Okay, so Germany collects money. It is up 13 IPC. So they have 43 IPC plus 1 NO plus 5. So that makes it 48 IPC that they have to, can spend in the next round. So we'll move to UK Pacific. So UK Pacific purchases is the following. They have 27 IPC. They buy a transport, a destroyer, and 3 mechs. So UK Pacific has 1 attack only, and it moved 1 infantry here in Ethiopia, making this for the UK Pacific. So now let's go to the non-combat moves for UK Pacific. UK Pacific collects income. It collects 1 more for taking Ethiopia. It's not at war yet. It can only declare war the next turn, beginning of next turn. So it collects now 28 IPC, and the turn will go to Japan. So Japan's purchases are the following: 1 bomber, 4 infantry, 2 tanks, and a mech. So let's go to the combat moves. Now this is the second turn of Japan, and I think this is the best turn for Japan to declare war, because UK Pacific does not have had the opportunity to declare war, did not collect any NOs. So what I want to do now is I want to take away as much NOs from them as possible. I see that if I get one combat move, so that's also a combat move. So they are attacking everywhere they can, in China as much as possible, and also Guangdong, Malaya, France Indochina, Xi'an State, and the Philippines. So this turn, Japan really need to go up in income and take some NOs from UK Pacific and one from the US. Japan was successful in all its combats. These are the losses of this turn. So Japan lost 4 infantry and a submarine, killed 2 destroyers, a fighter, and a whole bunch of infantry. So now they are here: Philippines, Malaya, Shanstead, Siam, French Indochina, Guangdong, and half of China. So let's do the non-combat moves for Japan. So that was Japan's turn. Japan collects now 44 IPC. It does not get any NOs, at least not yet. And the turn goes to UK Europe. And UK Europe has quite some money to spend. That is 37 IPC. And for that, we'll purchase airbase, minor industrial complex, an armored a tank, and a mech. So UK Europe will do only one attack, that's here in Iraq, and we will see how the dice will roll. So the battle was successful for UK Europe. It took one hit, so one infantry is dead. So now we will do the non-combat moves. So all the planes will land here in Cairo. Two fighters, one tech, and a bomber. Also this infantry will move there. Then if we go to the other side here, we have the destroyer and the cruiser. We'll go 1, 2, 3 into 92. 3 fighters will land here in Gibraltar. The transport will also come down. He will pick up the mech and one guy and join here. So that's it. So let's move the camera. The other non-combat moves we'll do here. This transport will go 1, 2. And two infantry will go into here. So he's able to pick it up. And then let's see, how much do we have here? 4, 5. Okay, just did some calculation. I think this destroyer should go here. Just in case Italy wants to come in here, he will deny the coastal bombardment. Okay. So that are all the non-combat movements for the UK. So they will put on their builds. Airbase will go into Gibraltar. The MAC and the tank will go here into the Union of South Africa. And the minor industrial complex will go into Prussia. So UK Europe collects its income. It receives 32 IPC. Plus 3 for the NOs. So the turn will go to Italy then. Italy has 13 IPC to spend. And for that it will purchase one fighter. And save 3 IPC for the next round. So the situation for Italy is quite grim, and as Axis I realized I made a mistake by letting this fleet go when it was still here. Germany should have taken it out, but he chose not to. He had other priorities. I think that is a strategic error, because now as a UK player, I saw this opportunity. I moved in here, have my free plane scramble here with my airbase. So as a UK player, I have quite a good defense here. It's too weak to attack. I only have one fighter, one bomber, a cruiser, and a destroyer. So yeah, if I attack this, I just don't have the odds to win this battle. What I would like to do is attack Cairo, but if I do that, even if Italy is successful, it is still screwed, because probably the remaining forces from the UK are able to take it back, plus the fleet that is here, plus those fighters will be able to take out the fleet that is here. So what I will do instead is a little bit conservative, that I don't know really much else what I can do here at this moment. So I will attack Greece and just try to pick up some IPC for Italy, and hope for better times. But don't think they will really come. Well, at least Italy was successful in taking Greece. They did it without casualties, so that was something Italy could use at this moment. To move its planes back to Rome. It will retreat all the forces to northern Italy. Like that. Those forces will move here. Should I retreat here? I think I'll leave it there. So, well, that's it for Italy. And of course, we have to put our plane here, and we will do it here in southern Italy. So Italy collects 14 IPC, does not get any NOs. It saved 3 IPC, so it will take 17 IPC to the next round. Then is the turn of China. China has 15 IPC, and for that it will purchase 5 infantry. So China will do 2 combat, 2 attacks. One here in Kuaichou, and one here in Suiyuan. It will move 2 infantry here in Kuaichou with the fighter, and the remaining infantry will move into here. Okay, the outcome of the battles is as follows. This is taken by China. They lost 1 infantry. And this also taken by China, and they did not take any casualties. Okay, so for the other non-combats for China, they'll move their fighter back here, defended by 3 infantry. They put 1 infantry here. Now let's make that 2 infantry. So that's the situation for China. Now China is down to 7 IPC, so it's not doing great. It hopes to get the road back with the help of a UK Pacific, otherwise this will be very meager. So the turn will go to Russia now. Russia has still 37 IPC to spend, and this is their purchase. They spend their money on 9 infantry, an artillery, and a tank. So Russia is now officially at war, and yeah, it looks like Germany is going full force on Russia. So Russia will get a very difficult time. What we will try to do now is to delay Germany as much as possible. For now, we will try to keep Novgorod and see if we can keep it for one more turn. And other than that, we'll just vacate to safe places. It's not an option to attack. Actually, if Germany wait one more turn, then Russia is much more much better able to be aggressive, because much more artillery have been going to the front. But so Germany decided to attack the second turn, which in my opinion is quite optimal, considering that I cannot really defend myself very well as Russia. So we will do only one attack, that is here in the Baltic States. And by the way, I forgot the convoy from the Russian sub at the end of the German turn. I just throw the dice, the 4-1, so we'll subtract one IPC from the income from Germany. So the battle went as planned for Russia and did not take any casualties. So the Baltic States is back in Russian hands and effectively creates a blocker for any tanks that would like to go up north. So we'll do all the non-combat moves now. Russia puts its newly purchased units down. Three infantry, six infantry in Russia, plus the artillery and a tank. And what I forgot, here in Buryatia, I'll move the camera. We will move everything into Amur. That is to put pressure on Japan. So now Russia collects 36 IPC. It is down one, but it does get one NO. So together that makes 41 IPC. And then it's the turn of the US. So the US has this turn still 52 to spend. The US is at war with the Axis now. And it purchases this, two infantry, five transports, and a tactical bomber. Okay, so the US is doing two combat moves. One is with this destroyer going to 103, 123, supported by the bomber, which flies 1, 2, 3, 4, and has free fuel in it left. This fleet will go 1, 2, 3 in 108 and attack this submarine. Okay, in both cases the US was successful in taking out the subs. They did not fire back, or they fired back but they missed. So we'll do the non-combat then. The bomber will land in London. Sorry, I see that I still have to swap this for an infantry. Here, this submarine will, or submarine transport will go 1, 2, 3 in 86. Land this artillery there and taking Brazil. One other thing we will do is we will move the one infantry from the Pacific side of the board to this side of the board. And let's get now to the Pacific side of the board. Here on the Pacific side, we will not do any attacks. We will move this fleet, The two transports will take the infantry and artillery. They will sail down here to 54 and offload here in Queensland. And also one of the land-based fighters is also flying here to Queensland. That's it for the non-combat moves for the US. Let's put down the purchased units. So one more time, we move to this side of the board to put down the purchased units for the US. Five transports, tactical bomber, two infantry. So the United States still has an income of 52. But now it gets also 20 for annals. So it will end with 72 IPC. And now it's the turn of France, and they don't have money. So we'll go straight into their moves. Now France is not doing any combat moves, just some non-combat moves. So this infantry will also go into Egypt. This one will move into France, Equatorial Africa, and last of all, this destroyer will go to Seasone 39. And that's it for the French moves. Okay, so that was the end of the second game round. I think, in retrospect, it's still undecided, but what we can see is that the Africa token most likely will be taken by the Allies quite quickly. Italy is not a match anymore for England in the Mediterranean, and soon the US will also join. It has six transports fully loaded coming to Europe, and they can do quite some harm to the access over there. So still it is feasible for Germany to go after Moscow. And allies have to put a lot of energy in preventing that. So I think Germany is very strong. Should be possible to take Moscow and perhaps then get that token and also get the token for seven victory cities on the Europe side of the board. So in that case, it would probably be 2-1. But of course, also Germany have to put a lot of energy in supporting Italy and preventing any more tokens from going to the Allies on that side. On the Pacific side of the board, it's really undecided. US did not purchase anything on that side. So it's UK Pacific has itself positioned. China is not doing bad, also not doing great. So yeah, it's really undecided on that side of the board. Well, thank you very much. And if you have any comments, you can leave them. Thank you for your time, and see you in the next episode.